It's time for our daily devotion. Daily abiding in Jesus Christ. In the book of John chapter 15 verse 7. If ye abide in me, and my words abide in you, ye shall ask what ye will, and it shall be done unto you. A daily devotional ministry project of Cristuto Genobaga from passages taken from the Holy Scriptures with quotations from the Spirit of Prophecy by Ellen G. White. Daily abiding in Jesus Christ.
June 20th, 2020. Romans 5 verses 1 to 8. 1. Therefore being justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. 2. By whom also we have access by faith into this grace wherein we stand, and rejoice in hope of the glory of God. 3. And not only so, but we glory in tribulations also, knowing that tribulation worketh patience. 4. And patience, experience, and experience, hope. 5. And hope maketh not ashamed, because the love of God is shed abroad in our hearts by the Holy Ghost which is given unto us. 6. For when we were yet without strength, in due time Christ died for the ungodly. 7. For scarcely for a righteous man will one die, yet peradventure for a good man some would even dare to die. 8. But God commendeth his love toward us, in that, while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us.
Quotations from the Spirit of Prophecy. Grace is an attribute of God exercised toward undeserving human beings. We did not seek for it, but it was sent in search of us. God rejoices to bestow his grace upon us, not because we are worthy, but because we are so utterly unworthy. Our only claim to his mercy is our great need. Ministry of Healing, page 161. In the place where sin abounded, God's grace much more abounds. The earth itself, the very field that Satan claims as his, is to be not only ransomed but exalted. Our little world, under the curse of sin, the one dark blot in his glorious creation, will be honored above all other worlds in the universe of God. By Ellen G. White, Desire of Ages, page 26.
Our prayer for today, dear God, our Father in heaven, it is with utmost humility that we approach your holy presence because you are all-powerful, our Creator and the entire universe, the only one who is good and loving. Today, we approach your presence with awe and reverence. Our prayer today as sinners, give us the faith of Jesus Christ that will become part of us, the only way that we experience justification through grace and not of our good works. What a gift! Help us, Father, to be crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, we live, not we, but Christ lives in us, and the lives that we now live in the flesh, we live by the faith of the Son of God, who loves us and died for us. Thank you, Father, for answering our prayer because we pray in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen.